lot of playing time in, you know, so for people to expect him to just come out and hair on fire, you know, he still didn't have that full experience as a starting quarterback in the Pac-12 under his belt, you know, so he also had to get some adjustment going, you know, and get used to it. So it took him to get some adjustment and then us getting adjusted to him as he's continuing to grow, you know, and become more mature and become more knowledgeable, you know, and read coverages and get more comfortable back there, you know, when pressure's in his face to make those throws. So it's definitely been a growing process for all of us.
And what has really been some of the keys for you to all of a sudden say, hey, oh, wow, okay, I know he's getting better at that, or he's doing, I mean, have you seen some things that have been really noticeable, especially the last couple of weeks with him coming back?
Yeah, his attention to detail is a lot more, you know, talkative, you know, talking to the receivers, letting us know, you know, what he sees and how he wants us to do stuff. And, you know, talking to the O-line, come on, you know, encouraging the O-line and get them if they're not doing something. You know, so it's definitely more vocal.
And I know that everyone's real excited to see that Kaysen was able to get a first down catch and start to assimilate a little bit more. Do you expect that role is going to get even bigger and bigger as you go at the end of the year?
Definitely. I definitely do. You know, I mean, Kaysen is a phenomenal receiver. You know, so the more comfortable he gets and, the more the game progresses and we continue to grow in the season, I think he's going to definitely, you know, get some more catches.
Start to see kind of the Kaysen that we all kind of remember and know?
Yeah. Yeah, definitely.
You get a sense from him at all that this is difficult, just mentally not being as big a part of the offense as he would have liked and everybody would have liked, and just the injury and everything. What's the sense you get from Kaysen?
I feel like he's handled it really well. He's handled it really well. You know, a lot better than I think a lot of people would. You know, he comes in, you know, every day ready to work. You know, and, you know, give us all, you know, compete and, you know, put his best foot forward out there. You know, circumstances, you know, may not be the best for him, you know, as far as, you know, injury, you know, playing time being where he was before, you know, but he's handled that really well.
Seems like the defensive guys are pretty excited to see Shaq running the ball and how well he's doing there. How do the offensive guys feel about John maybe getting some time on defense?
Honestly, we're just all in for what's best for the team. You know, and, you know, if John Ross can help us out on defense, you know, help us get the win, then we're all for it. We're not, you know, just like, man, why isn't he playing offense? You know, we're not, you know, mad or anything like that. We're just, you know, supporting what the coaches want to do and if they think that's best, you know, for us to get the win. And, you know, John Ross is a phenomenal athlete as well. You know, he can do a lot of things people can't do. If he gets beat on a route, he can definitely catch up to the receiver.
I was going to say, did you have any double takes, though, when you were lined up and all of a sudden you see number one on the other side?
Oh, no. I take it as a challenge. You know, I mean, we already talked about that because he played some deviant spring ball, too. So he was talking about, you know, all season, like, Dre, I'll lock you up, you know, I'll D you up, and all this type of stuff. So, I mean, see him on the other side of the ball, it just alerted me more, like, oh, yeah, Ross, let's go. It's time to go. So it's been fun.
Does he help simulate what you expect to see from UCLA on Saturday?
Yeah, you know, they do have a small corner, you know, Ishmael Adams. You know, he's a short corner, but, you know, he's also a quick corner as well, you know, so getting Ross on the other side of the ball and getting those looks as well, you know, definitely.
What else have you seen from them so far on tape?
UCLA?
Yeah.
They're very athletic defense, and they just have a lot of guys that can just make plays.
Hey, just from the first game to now, how have you seen sort of Silent grow, if he has it all?
It's experience. Experience. You know, there's no better lesson, you know, as a player than to get that experience under your belt so you understand the different situations that you might be in the game. Like, you can't practice. You can practice certain things, but at the same time, you can't simulate what the game is like. You know, feeling the emotions that you get, you know, you simulate what the defense is going to do in practice, but they may do something different or it may not fit up right. You know, so get him that experience, you know, so he can become more comfortable and then allow him to grow as a leader on the offense, you know, as a quarterback. So that's definitely – I've definitely seen him grow in all those aspects. You know, mature, more poised, you know, calm, and just, you know, making his reads.
Does he anticipate – the movements of the receivers, like have an idea of when you're going to come out of your break and then put it on you, sort of like right where guys like it?
Yeah.
Do you sort of see things like that?
Yeah, he definitely does. You know, and that just came with repetition. And, you know, it's been a season where, you know, sometimes, you know, the ball may not have been where we want it to be, or, you know, it may have been off because of the line, so he may not have been able to throw exactly at the time that he was supposed to throw. But, you know, for the most part, we've been working on it, you know, and we've been doing a good job so far. DeAndre,